If you saw Avengers Endgame, and there's no doubt you did, clearly just by looking at the box office, you probably realize that in Endgame, Captain Marvel has a very minimal role. Same with T'Challa the Black Panther. This was actually made by choice and due to scheduling, so let's talk about this. So in Avengers Infinity War, we see Black Panther. We go to Wakanda and, you know, we spend a little bit of time there and, of course, the final battle, and that's really important. In Captain Marvel's case, she shows up in Endgame right at the beginning, at the end, and that's that. Obviously, she looks different. Time has passed since her prequel film, and a lot of people are questioning why was the choice made to use these characters like this. As most of you know if you watch this channel, but a lot of the general public doesn't know, things were shot out of order. When they were shooting Black Panther, this was after they shot his appearances for Infinity War and Endgame. Same thing with Captain Marvel. Brie Larson first suited up as Captain Marvel in Endgame. So they had a little window to try to establish what the character was doing, her attitude, and her power level. But the script was still being written for Captain Marvel. So ultimately, the Russo brothers and the writers and everybody else involved decided these characters need to have smaller roles. Not because we don't want to use them, not because of anything else. Essentially, they need to because the way that Infinity War was structured, Black Panther could have more of an impact, and we see that. But then going into Endgame, it was a story about the original Avengers. And then T'Challa's involvement there isn't important considering he was dusted and he comes back and now he's going to be the future of the MCU along with Captain Marvel. And that's definitely established at the end when she shows up and shows off her powers. So it was more of a way to make people understand that these characters weren't important to what we were doing right now, but they're important to the future. So we're going to show you that. But we have to wrap up the story of the old Avengers before we touch upon the new ones. And when you think of it that way, everything starts to make a lot more sense.